Plants are the backbone of lives on Earth. They are the heartbeat of the home planet, and they are usually seen as harmless, silent green living things that kill no one. Really? Though most of the species of plants take nutrients from soil, water, and sun, here are a very few species of plants that look at nutrition in a different way. They believe in killing and eating and digesting every bit and piece of other living organism. But what are these plants? Why do they eat other organisms? How do they digest them? How many different kinds are there? Know it all in this video. About 70 million years ago, when dinosaurs roamed the earth, a genetic change allowed some plants to turn into meat eaters, or carnivores. Carnivory in plants has evolved independently about 6 times, and today there are more than 600 known species of carnivorous plants. Carnivorous plants, also known as insectivorous plants, tend to grow in soils which have low nutrients and where the soil is acidic. They acquire most of their nutrients from trapping and consuming animals or insects. They capture and digest insects and other animals in 5 different ways. Pitfall traps. Look at this plant. It is called the pitcher plant. This plant attracts its prey with nectar bribes secreted within its pitcher. The linings of most pitcher plants are covered in a loose coating of waxy flakes, which are slippery for insects. When an insect is lured towards the plant for the nectar, it slips and falls into the pitcher. Once within the pitcher structure, digestive enzymes break down the prey into an absorbable form for the plant. These kinds of plants are called pitfall traps. Flypaper traps. The flypaper trap utilizes glue to catch their prey. The leaf of flypaper traps has a glue called mucilage. These mucilages can be short, like those of the butterworts plants, or long, like those of many sundews plants. Once an insect gets stuck, the enzymes start to break them down. Snap traps. There are only 2 plants which are snap traps. One of them is the Venus flytrap. Even Darwin was mesmerized by this plant, describing it as one of the most wonderful in the world. When an insect lands on these plants, their mouth-like leaves literally snap shut and digest the insect. Another type of snap traps is found underwater. They are known as the water wheel plants and eat prey in a similar manner. Bladder traps. These seems to be the most interesting type of carnivorous plants. They have sacs underwater known as bladder. This bladder creates a vacuum and sucks the insects inside the bladder. The vacuum is created by removing water from the bladders by using osmosis. Osmosis is a process by which water can move from a less concentrated region to a more concentrated region. This worm is now digested by using various digestive enzymes. Lobster pot trap. These plants trap their prey from roots. When an insect touches the plant, it enters its tunnel-like roots, which have bristles pointed inwards. Now the insect can only move in one direction. Insects can enter, but there is no exit. The insect then reaches the central chamber, where various enzymes and low oxygen kills the insect. All these plants are the wonders of nature. Though these are the examples of plants being harmful, but plants are the ones that are being harmed the most. As for eating prey, that's just nature's circle of life.